this is what a healthy brain looks like. Compare it to someone who had a stroke. Strokes are a disaster for brain function. This is why you shouldn't smoke. Did you know that smoking is the number one cause of strokes? This is what Alzheimer's disease looks like. Alzheimer's disease ravages brain function. Now, our brain scans can tell 5 to 10 years before you have symptoms whether or not you're likely to get it. But you want to be working early to prevent Alzheimer's disease because it's a nightmare for brain function. The real reason not to use drugs? They damage your brain. And if they damage your brain, they damage your life. So here's, for my own patients, this is a cocaine brain, a methamphetamine brain, an alcoholic brain, and a heroin brain. The one question you always want to ask yourself if you want to be successful is, which brain do you want? Is your behavior day in and day out every day helping or hurting your brain? You want to ask yourself that question every day. Now, when we come back, I'm going to show you how to be happier, more focused, less anxious, and less depressed by balancing these very interesting three systems in your brain. I'm also going to show you this very sneaky way to deal with difficult people in your life. Stay tuned.
For a change your brain, change your life. Thanks.
Thank you. Welcome back. I love this segment because I'm going to teach you what I call practical brain science to make your life better. As you will see, brain science is eminently practical because your brain's involved in everything you do. In the next few minutes, I'm going to introduce you to three parts of your brain that drive a great deal of your behavior. We're going to talk about an area of your brain called the prefrontal cortex. It works as like the boss in your head. And we're going to talk about your cingulate. That's the brain's gear shifter. And then we're going to talk about your limbic or your emotional brain. As you will see, knowing how to optimize these systems will improve everything in your life, even the other people. Whenever we discuss humans, the first area of the brain that we have to talk about is the prefrontal cortex. It's largest in human beings than in any other animal by far. This is the part of your brain that actually makes you human. It's 30% of the human brain, 11% of the chimpanzee brain, 7% of your dog's brain. This is my dog, Fraser. Isn't he cute? I love Fraser. And how many of you have cats? Love your cat. Well, this is my cat, Annabelle. And cats have virtually no prefrontal cortex. Cats have no forethought, very little impulse control. Annabelle lives totally in the moment. She doesn't think about the past. She doesn't worry about the future. It's just now. Now is all that matters. So the prefrontal cortex is the executive part of the brain. It works in your head like the boss at work. Things like focus and forethought, judgment, impulse control, empathy, learning from the mistakes that you make. This is the part of your brain that's involved in maturity. When there are problems in this part of the brain, you act like a cat. I mean, how many times have I told her, don't do this? Doesn't matter. Okay, when there are problems in this part of the brain, what we see is short attention span, impulse control problems. They procrastinate, they put things off, they have bad judgment, they don't have much empathy, and they don't learn from the mistakes that they make. Haven't you ever wondered about yourself or someone else? It's like, why aren't they learning? Why aren't they getting it? And it's because this part of the brain may not be getting good function. So when we see low activity in this part of the brain, it's It's associated with people who have bad habits. You know that person who always shows up to work 10 minutes late with a big cup of coffee? Odds are low activity in this part of the brain. Or people who smoke, or internet gambling. Low activity, they're looking to stimulate it. People have attention deficit disorder. You've heard about ADD, very commonly diagnosed in children, but did you know it's also very common in adults? Most of the kids who have it grow up and have it as well. And our research studies and other people's research as well has shown low activity in this part of the brain. People who have a weak conscience, who make decisions, and you're just like, why did you do that? Low persistence, they can't stick with things. Some forms of depression, especially low energy forms of depression, and people who are excitement or conflict seeking. Do you know anybody like this? These are people who play this game I call, let's have a problem. It's like they need to be upset in order to concentrate. It's like being upset actually stimulates their brain and helps them feel more normal. So as kids, they pick on their brothers. As spouses, they may pick on their spouse, right? Or they may be stirring it up at work. So what do you do? How do you treat this? If you have problems in this part of the brain, which are very common, well, one of the things that we found to be so helpful is getting them to write out their goals. It's an exercise we call the one-page miracle. On one piece of paper, write out what you want in your relationships. What do you want at work? What's your goal? What do you want for your money? And what do you want for your physical and emotional and spiritual health? What do you want? Write it out. And then you look at it every day and you go, is my behavior getting me what I want? The second thing is exercise. Exercise actually boosts blood flow to this part of the brain. Now, I have a specialty in people that have attention deficit disorder. And many people ask me, okay, I don't really want to take medicine. What is the best natural treatment for ADD? And what it is, it's intense aerobic exercise along with a high protein, low carbohydrate diet. Now, this diet is not good for everybody. But for people who have ADD or people who have low activity in the front part of their brain and they have trouble with concentration and they're disorganized and they procrastinate, this is a great diet for them because it helps their energy and it helps them concentrate. Fish oil. Fish oil is so helpful. Now we'll talk about it later, but for now just know it helps increase your energy and your concentration. And if needed, there are certain natural supplements and certain medications that can be so helpful. And in my book, Change Your Brain, Change Your Life, I talk about what those are. The next part of the brain that I want to teach you about or talk to you about is called the cingulate gyrus. So here we're looking at the brain from the left side. So this is the back to the right. Here's the front. And this area right here in the front is called the cingulate gyrus. And it's so interesting. Now, the cingulate, that's like a big word. But what it basically means is this is the brain's gear shifter. It allows you to shift your attention. Right? To go from idea to idea or go from task to task. It also helps you be flexible. To go with the flow. So you don't have to have things your way. It's heavily involved in seeing options. You know, people that are rigid, it has to be their way. There's no option. When it works right, you can see many different options. Which means it helps you cooperate. It helps you get outside of your head and into the head of other people. It's hugely also involved in error detection. So if you walk into a room and you see something that's out of place, it's the cingulate gyrus that's telling you this is out of place. And when it works too hard, if you want to make those people crazy, just like move something. You know, like turn the picture a little bit or mess with something, and they just, I know it's wrong. Something's wrong. Something's wrong. Now, when there are problems in this part of the brain, when it works too hard, which is usually due to a deficit in the neurotransmitter serotonin, and when